Good morning. Hello, mic test. Naririnig niyo ba ako? Can you hear me? Parang palakas-lakas nga, sir. Hello, mic testing. Hello, mic test. Okay. Let's pray. Let's pray once more. Our Father in heaven, we come to you, Lord, this morning. We humble ourselves. We ask for the Holy Spirit, Lord, to be with us, with the congregation, Lord, your children. I especially ask that you guide me, Lord, as I deliver your word to your children. I don't know what they need. I don't know where they are in their life. So please possess me, Lord, these very hours, that I might bring them, help them to be closer to you, Lord. Thank you for hearing our prayers. Thank you for the church. Thank you for the opportunity to study your word. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Spiritual disciplines. Ang ibig sabihin ng discipline ay marami pong ibig sabihin yan. May discipline na disiplina sa ating sarili. Merong discipline na dinidisiplina tayo ng Diyos. So, malawak ang discussion. So these are practical tools for personal transformation. Of course, when we say transformation, we find it in the Bible. It says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good. The reason we are being renewed is because our minds are not perfect, right? We are not perfect, therefore, kailangan natin ng salita ng Diyos. Psalms 19:7 says, the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. Kung merong bagay na nakaka-convert ng kaluluwa, yan daw po ang batas ng Diyos. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. Kaya pala yung mga tao sa Bible, pag nakita nila yung law ng Diyos, yung salita ng Diyos, pag nabasa nila yung mga sinulat ng mga prophets, sila ay nagsisisi, nakikita nila ang kanilang kamalian, at sila ay nagbabago dahil ang batas ng Diyos. Kaya pala tayo mga Adventists ay mahilig sa Ten Commandments. Meron akong ministering tinutulungan. Ewan ko kung alam nyo yun, yung kapitulo, versikulo. Halos 80% ng ginagamit ng Diyos yung ministry, makadala ng mga tao sa church, halos 80% ng converts na testimony, ang naka-convert daw silang sa kanilang message ay yung Sabbath. Sabbath, ang ikalawa daw na pinaka nakaka-convert, according dun sa mga testimony na narinig ko po, ay yung tungkol sa pagkain. Baboy, Leviticus 11. Ang sunod daw doon ay tungkol doon sa true church na presentation. Kaya pala talagang totoo yun na sa Psalms 19:7 na the law of the Lord is perfect. It is the one that converts the soul, di ba? So yun yung nakasulat sa Bible. Transforming by the renewing of your mind. So we are going to look at what is written in God's law through the prophets so that our minds and our lives will be converted. What is the gospel of Christ? Is it going to heaven when we die? Yes, maybe. Sins are forgiven. It's part of it. Ah, yan ang hindi tayo yata naniniwala. Once you're in, you can never get kicked out. So that's a different one. So it says here the gospel is bigger. So there are many aspects of the gospel. Life in the kingdom of heaven is now available. Where is that? If you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if, oh, by the way, yung now dyan kasi, sabi sa Bible, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Yan lang ibig sabihin ng now. If you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. So there is a contest between our body, our flesh, our will, and the will of the Spirit. There is a contention. Kaya sinabi nating spiritual discipline para lumakas yung ating spiritual life at humina yung ating lust, yung ating lower passions. Kaya meron tayo spiritual disciplines. The true transformation is possible in our lives. In the great controversy theme, the issue is God's law. Sabi ni Satanas sa langit, hindi pwedeng sundan ang batas ng Diyos, kailangan baguhin. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, pwede. He lived an example without sin to prove that transformation is possible in our lives, not by our own means, it is impossible, but by God's will, by God's grace, everything is possible. Okay. We can experience eternal life while living here on earth. How? Matthew 14:19 says, "Come and follow me." Okay, marami yan sa Bible, pero yun lang yung kinuha kong reference. By following what Jesus did when he was on earth. Merong mayaman na Adventist na dinadrive ko punta sa airport. Galing sa airport, sabi niya sa akin, if somebody gives you 1 million, what are you going to do for the ministry? So sabi ko, based on the statistics in Jesus' activities, 70% health work, 30% teaching, 10%, 20%, and then 10% preaching. So, we are going to see what in the Bible Jesus is doing. He arranged his life around certain activities and practices. Like what? I just read The Desire of Ages, yung kabataan ni Jesus Christ na chapter. What Jesus Christ was doing, he was a carpenter. He did manual labor. Perfect manual labor. He studied the word. Kaya si Jesus Christ nung tinutukso ng Satanas, sabi niya, it is written, it is written. Pag mayroong tinatanong sa kanya yung Pharisees, according to Moses, according to like this, according to Isaiah, according. Kasi alam niya yung salita ng Diyos through the prophets. Of course, he was a man of prayer. That's why the disciples wanted him to ask, to teach them how to pray. And the nice, very nice line I found in the Desire of Ages was this. His life was, ang goal niya sa life is to be a blessing to others. Kaya pala, naintindihan ko yung ibang mga pastor na papakainin kayo, papasakain kayo, di ba ganun? Their goal is to be a blessing to others. Desire of Ages chapter 7. So what did these activities bring? Minsan, detachment. Minsan, like Enoch, he was detached from the city. Ayaw niyang maahawaan siya ng influence ng city. Kaya doon siya sa bundok na nanalangin at nagre-refill ng kanyang spiritual life. Si Jesus din ay mahilig pumunta dun sa bundok at manalangin. Ayan. And of course, you don't just pray and fast and study the Bible like the Pharisees. Di ba po yung mga Pharisees, nananalangin sila, nagpa-fasting sila, tsaka nagpe-pray sila. Bakit hindi nila na-gets yung mission? Ang kulang sa kanila ay missionary work. They did not go to Voice of Youth. They did not go to evangelism. So pag nanalangin kayo at nagpray, nanalangin, nagfasting at nagstudy ng Bible, pero hindi kayo nag-outreach para tayong Pharisee. Oh, in fact, yung Pharisee, dahil nainggit sila, masikat si Jesus Christ, pinersecute nila yung missionary. So dapat balance. We have to be engaged and we have to do the Great Commission, Matthew 28:19, because the Bible says, "Go ye therefore." So we try to have our life around the activities which Jesus did. Okay. These are some of the things, but we will just go through like this. Solitude. Why? Because in Psalms 4:10, it says, "Be still and know that I am God." Siyempre, di ba? Sabi nung kaibigan ko, para daw hindi ka masiraan ng ulo, you have to spend 1 hour every day just, you know, processing the things that happened yesterday, those things, and planning for. So there's time to be still and know that I am God. Of course, this is the best thing if Jesus did it. That's why he wants to go to the mountain and to the hills and pray. To get away from the crowd and do nothing. Actually, it's not do nothing. It's synchronizing our minds with the mind of God. Silence. Habakkuk 2:20 says, "Let all the earth keep silence before him." Okay. Getting away from human noise. Fasting. Kanina yung diniscuss ni Kuya Melvin ang fasting. I will just have some story about fasting. It's not perfect fasting, but Pastor, I experimented with fasting. Kasi meron tayong kaibigan, sabi ko, bakit hindi ka kumakain pag Sabado ng tanghali? Ang ministry ko po ay ipag-drive itong mga to. Sila Dave, sa mga outreach. Tapos sabi nung isa sa kaibigan namin, hindi siya kumakain. sabi niya, nagpa-fasting daw kasi siya. Eh, ako mahilig mangopya. Pag nag-outreach sila, kopya. Pag nag-Bible study, kopya. Nung may nakita ako nagpa-fasting, sabi ko, kukopihin ko rin. I want to experiment. Pag may nakita tayong maganda, subukan natin kopihin. So, sinubukan ko one semester ng buong araw ng Sabado, hindi ako kumakain. Simula lang umaga, hindi hanggang sunset. Simula umaga hanggang pagka-sunset, saka na ako, ano, sabi ko hindi naman ako mamamatay kasi sanay naman ako na nakakalimutan kong kumain sa sobrang dami. So, kung sa klase nga nakaka-fasting, nakakalimutan natin kumain. Experiment naman to, hindi naman decision. I'm just experimenting what will happen. So, I experimented for one semester, whole Sabbath day since morning to sunset, I did not eat. Masakit sa ulo pala kasi hindi ko naparinig pa yung lecture ni ano eh. Actually, something happens to our blood when we fast. In the internet, there's a graph of things that happen on day one, day two, day three to the chemistry of the blood. So I just tried. Anyway, pag sumasakit yung ulo, tutulog mo lang konti. Pagising mo, medyo okay ka na. But the nice thing about, the thing about fasting is, I tried it before, hindi gumagana kung wala kang ginagawa. Dapat mag-fasting, this is not, I'm not saying it's like this, I'm just saying my experience, okay? I tried it before, it was not working for me because I was not doing anything. I was just waiting, ilang oras na lang, hinihintay ko ganun yung oras. Pero nung nag-outreach kami, tapos hindi ka lang kakain, gumagawa ka pa rin, you do Bible study, you do VBS and other things. So I was just doing, after 1 year, I'm not a theology like this lucky people, theology majors. Naging akong speaker ng crusade, first time. Dalawang tapos second time. Tapos, halos every Sabbath, kahit saan ako pumuntang church, ako yung speaker sa hour of worship. Wala namang arrangement, nakikita lang nila, nakabarong ako. Nakabarong ka, di ba taga-AUP ka? Ikaw na speaker. So, hindi ko na maintindihan kung anong nangyayari. Dumami yung ministry, yung church planting, nakatulong ako ng dalawang church planting. Sabi ko, wala naman nangyari sa akin, wala naman nagbago sa akin. But siguro, when you fast, God just arranges everything, puts everything together so that you can do more ministry. So that is my experience. So, napagod ako, Pastor. Daming speaking appointments. Nakakasawa na nga yung sermon ko kasi paulit-ulit. Siguro mga 60 times ko nang sinermon yun. Nakadalawang crusade, dalawang sunod-sunod. So sinubukan kong tigilan yung fasting ko. Tumigil ako. Tumigil din, Pastor, ang crusade. Tumigil din ang church planting. Tumigil din ang speaker, ang speaking appointments. Therefore, na-prove ko na tama talaga. In my experience, meron pa akong isang friend. Sabi ko, bakit itong friend ko na ito? Ang galing mag-preach. Narinig ko siya sa ayas mag-preach. Hindi ko maintindihan yung outline niya. Lahat ng topic. Pero gustong-gusto siya. Pumunta ako dun sa HCLC, kahit sa ang CLC camp, siya ang speaker. Doon, sa Manila Center, doon, sa Klaa, doon. Si Pastor Paul. So, ginagaya ko ito, Pastor. At pinag-arrange ng Diyos ang mga pangyayari na ako ang nagda-drive sa kanya. So, inoobserbahan ko siya. Nung nandun kami sa hotel, sabi ko, Pastor, sabi niya, galing kami sa AUP, pray kami. Drive ako hanggang Olongapo. Pagdating namin doon, sabi niya, Professor, please pray. Pray ako. Lumabas ako sa sakyan, siya nandun pa rin. Sabi na nangyari kay Pastor, baka hindi marunong magtanggal ng seatbelt. Pagtingin ko, nagpipray pa rin siya ng second service. Tapos pagkalabas niya, pagdating namin sa hotel, tig-isa kaming bed, sabi niya, you sleep 15 minutes, I will prepare. Pero hindi ako makatulog dahil gusto kong makinig ng sermon niya. Excited ako makinig ng salita ng Diyos. Nagpipikit-pikitan lang ako, tinitingnan ko siya, nakaluhod na naman. Nananalangan ng 15 minutes na naman. Hinintay kong magising, tumapos Pastor. Nung nag-arrange siya ng damit, sabi niya, my friend, please pray for me. Muntik na ako matawa kasi nananalangin na kami sa traffic, dun sa AUP, pati dun sa parking. Tapos natutulog ako, nananalangin siya. Pagkagising ko, sabi niya, please pray for me. Hindi pa na kontento. Sabi ko, Pastor, you already pray a lot. How come you say, please pray for me? Sabi niya, my friend, I have only one secret in my life. Tinaas niya, Pastor, yung kanyang pantalon. Hanggang makita ko yung tuhod. Doon lang ako nakakita ng tuhod na may kalyo. Nakakita na ba kayong tuhod na may kalyo? Tuhod na may kalyo. Naintindihan ko na kung bakit kahit saan siya pumunta, pag mag-speaker siya, i-approach siya ng 10 tao at gusto siyang i-invite ulit kung saan. Dahil yung prayer life niya. Tapos nalaman ko, next Sabbath, sabi ni speaker ako sa AUP, sabi niya, but please do not come to my house before 9. Because alam ko na, mananalangin muna siya simula 8 o'clock hanggang 9 o'clock. Mas mahalagang manalangin siya ng mas mahaba pa kaysa kanyang sermon kaysa dumating siya ng maaga sa church. So dali-dali kami. Sabi niya, I'm not, for the last 25 years, this is the only Sabbath I am eating in the morning because it is my fasting period ng Sabado ng umaga. So 24, 25 years pala siya na umaga lang ng Sabbath, hindi siya, yun yung fasting time niya. Kaya lang dahil inuubo siya at may antibiotic siya, kumakain siya ng tinapay. So fasting is, I don't know how to explain, but I know that it works. Subukan nyo na lang. So the Bible, there's lots of fasting in Acts. Jesus, most of the Elijah, Moses, everything that has something to do very greatly about our salvation, there was some fasting involved. How be it, this kind goeth not out but by prayer and fasting. Yung mga evil spirits na hindi nila mapugaw, mayroong mas madali, may mas mahirap. Yung mas mahirap, sabi ni Jesus Christ, kailangan ng prayer and fasting. Kung anong klase mang fasting yung sinabi ni kaya Melvin, yung partial, yung full water, yung fruits lang, saka yung Facebook fasting, ganun din yata ako naririnig eh. So, frugality and sacrifice, why? Because Jesus says unto him, the foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man hath not where to lay his head. Okay, so, ang boss natin, si Jesus Christ, ay matipid, hindi magastos. Therefore, we can also copy chastity. Ibig sabihin nito sa mga mag-asawa, you can skip for a time of fasting and prayer, but make sure you come together again to avoid temptation. Sabi sa 1 Corinthians 7:5. Okay, secrecy, why? Because if we do good, sabi sa Bible, we should not make a parade out of it. Halimbawa, nagbibigay tayo ng ganito, ilalagay pa natin sa... Yun yung sabi sa Bible. Okay. Bakit daw? Kasi pag if the people give glory to us, there will be no credit in heaven. But if we do not say, then the Heavenly Father who sees what is done in secret will reward. Okay. So ang ginagawa natin minsan, yung iba ipapakita natin to be a good example, pero yung iba hindi natin papakita para may reward pa sa langit. Di ba? Study. The Bible says, 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show yourself approved unto God. Kaya mag-aral na kayo sa AUP kahit mahal. Advertisement kasi taga-AUP. Okay. Worship and celebration, Psalm 150. Oh, that's... sabi ko sa mga pinsan ko, mga pinsan, panindigan nyo ang pangalan natin kasi ang pangalan natin ay pasamba. We have to worship, di ba? But we are Christians, we have to worship Jesus Christ. Okay. Fellowship, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together. According to Hebrews 10:25, we have to fellowship with our fellow brothers and sisters. Service, ito ang pinakamaganda. But made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. That's what Jesus said, did while he was on earth. To bless others. Of course, praying. And he went and sent them away and departed into a mountain to pray. I gave an example already about that. Confession and submission. Why? Of course, because of our wrong. Yung hindi nagsisisi, mayabang, hindi tutulungan ng Diyos masyado. But when we repent, our sins are forgiven, and we are put right, our relationship is put right with God. What are the dangers? Ito ang problema. Problema ni Satanas. If you think you are attractive, if you think you are talented, oh, dami, pag sabi kong attractive, daming lumingon. If you think you are talented, if you think you have potential, be careful of Luciferitis. A proud look, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood. Those thou are an abomination to the Lord. Pantay-pantay yata yun, no? A proud look. Okay. We have to be careful with our pride. Ang pride pa naman, nalalaman lang natin. Ang pinakamahirap ma-detect na kasalanan ay ang pride. Naaalam na ng iba, tayo hindi pa natin alam. So we are going to the how. I have another presentation here that's very interesting. Related, very much related to spiritual disciplines. Because when we say spiritual disciplines, it is our for spiritual life. Now when we say spiritual life, it is the life that is driven by the Holy Spirit. The question is, what are the things in the Bible where the Holy Spirit was given to the people? So we want to see what did they do, what mind state they did so that they were the outpouring of the Holy Spirit was given to them. Let's see. This is the summary. Repentance, implicit trust, obedience, a burden to share, persistent intercession or prayer, honoring the body temple, a desire for Christ to live in the heart. Bakit honoring the body temple? Pag tayo ba ay nag-inom ng beer, will the Holy Spirit, ibang spirit ang pupunta sa atin, yung spirit ng glass. Okay, so we have two, these are the things that the Bible says. Okay, let's see. Acts 2:37, now when they heard this, they were pricked in the heart. Di po ba, mga kapatid, minsan may naririnig tayo sa Bible. Tinatamaan tayo sa ating puso dahil tama yung narinig natin at yung buhay natin ay medyo malayo sa will ng Diyos. And said unto Peter and the rest of the disciples, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the Holy Ghost. Repentance will cause the Holy Ghost to be received, according to Acts 2:37-38. Sabi ni Peter, kayo kasi, you crucified people. Therefore, you should repent and the Holy Ghost will be poured to you. Mark 1:15, and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Okay. 2 Corinthians 7:10, for godly sorrow, ibig sabihin, dahil yung sorrow natin, yung kalungkutan natin, is because we are correctly repenting, worketh repentance to salvation, not to be repented of, but the sorrow of the world worketh death. When we say the sorrow of the world, nagsisisi tayo because of the consequences, not because we hate sin. Of course, Hebrews 12:16 says, ito, we have to be careful. I know you live in the city, and I know in the city there are 10 times more temptations. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person, yung nagbabad words, as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright. For you know how that afterward when he would have inherited that blessing, he was rejected, and he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears. So, merong repentance na hindi totoo. Merong repentance na totoo. Ang nangyari kay Esau daw, according to Hebrews, ay rejected repentance. Romans 2:4, or despised thou the riches of goodness and forbearance and longsuffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leadeth thee to repentance. It is God's goodness that leads us to repentance. Okay, number two. What is implicit trust? Trust, we know. Implicit, what is it? Implied, rather than expressly stated, implicit agreement, unquestioning, unreserved, absolute. Okay. So that blessing of Abraham might become to the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. How we'll receive the Spirit? Like Abraham, through faith, implicit trust. What is the difference between feeling and faith? Feeling ko, I have faith. Oh, anong difference? Feeling is not faith. Ah, hindi pala maasahan ng ating feelings. The two are distinct. Faith is ours to exercise, but joyful feeling and the blessing are God's to give. True faith lays hold of and claims the promised blessing before it is realized and felt. Kahit hindi natin nararamdaman ang pagpapala na darating na ibibigay ng Diyos, we have to exercise faith even if we don't have feeling. Si Jesus Christ, nung ipapako siya sa cross, he did not depend on his feeling. He did not want to drink the cup, but he said, not my will, but your will. So through faith, okay, we must send our petitions in faith within the second veil and let our faith take hold of the promised blessing and claim it as ours. We are then to believe that we receive the blessing because our faith, kanina naririnig ko din sa likod, ang gusto nilang ipanalangin ay blessing. The spirit of prophecy says, you have to exercise your faith when you pray for blessing because our faith has hold of it. And according to the word, it is ours. Whatsoever things you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. Of course, according to the will of the Father in heaven. Here is faith, naked faith, to believe that we receive the blessing even before we realize it. When the promised blessing is realized and enjoyed, faith is swallowed up. But many suppose that they have much faith when sharing largely of the Holy Spirit, that they cannot have faith unless they feel the power of the Spirit. Such confound faith with a blessing that comes through faith. The very time to exercise faith, ito na lang ang tandaan natin, pinakahuli kasi ang haba nung ano. The very time to exercise faith is when we feel destitute of the Spirit. Minsan, where is the Holy Spirit? Where are you, Lord? This is the best time daw to exercise faith. And the other one, condition for receiving the Holy Spirit or disciplining our spiritual life is obedience. And we are His witnesses of these things, and so is also the Holy Ghost, whom God hath given to them that obey. Kanino binibigay ang Holy Ghost? To them that obey. Acts 5:32. Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my commandments, and my Father will love him, and will come unto him. The Father that will come unto those who keep the commandments and make our abode with him. Diba merong God lives in us and we in him? So according to John 14:23, when we obey, the Father is coming to us and lives, abides in us. Whoso keepeth his word in him, verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby we know that we are in him. Paano natin na malalaman na tayo ay nasa Diyos, na ang Diyos ay nasa atin? The measurement, evaluation, is obedience. 1 John 2:5. He that saith he abided in him, ought on himself also to walk, even as he walked. Okay. And of course, if we have a burden to share, the Holy Spirit will be given. If ye then, being evil, know how to good gifts, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask for him? In Luke, it says, it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said, teach us to pray. So, when we want to learn about spiritual things, we have a goal. We want to share it to others. It says in 6th Testimony, page 90, the Holy Spirit will come to all who are begging for the bread of life to give to their neighbors. Wow! So hindi lang pala tayo hihingi for the Holy Spirit, for spiritual discipline, for spiritual life, for us. Hindi lang para sa atin, so that we will overflow and be a blessing to others and also damay, para madamay yung iba sa outpouring of the Holy Spirit. One more is prayer, persistent intercession. Sabi dito, I say unto you, though he will not rise, ito yung kumakatok na neighbor, for everyone that asketh, receiveth. Ito po ang aking na-observe sa aking mga kaibigan at sabi nung ating pastor. Sabi ni Pastor Orbe, kahit ano daw hingiin natin, for our spiritual life, lagi daw yes ang sagot ng Diyos. Kasi for our spiritual improvement, ang sagot ng Diyos lagi dyan ay yes. As long as it is for our spiritual life. So kung gusto niyong sagutin ang prayer niyo, palitan niyo na yung prayer niyo na is beneficial for your own spiritual life and others also. Because everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, to him that knocketh it shall be opened. 1 Thessalonians 5:17 says, prayer without ceasing. Hebrews 4:16, let therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. For without faith it is impossible to please him, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Okay. Now this one, honoring the body temple. Question, pag kumakain tayo ng baboy, will the Holy Spirit come? Maybe, pag hindi natin alam. Because God winks at our ignorance. Ignorance ba ang tawag doon, or innocence? But if we are disobeying the laws of health, 1 Corinthians 6:9, what? Know ye not that your body, our body, is the temple of the Holy Ghost? So if we don't take care of the temple, where will the Holy Ghost stay? Ye are not your own, for ye are not, we are bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Okay. Sabi sa Revelation 14, fear God and give glory to Him, for the hour of His judgment is come. So lahat ng ginagawa natin sa ating katawan, we will be judged. Not only in the future, even now. Pag kumain tayo maraming masyadong asukal, pag hatching ng lahat ng tao, hatching din tayo. Pero na-observe ko mga kapatid, for 2 months, alam niyo mahilig ako mag-experiment. Sinubukan kong 2 months, hindi ako kumain ng kahit anong may asukal na luto. Yung mga fruits, natural sugar. Umatching na at umubo lahat ng tao. Ako, patawa-tawa lang ako. Totoo nga yung sinasabi ng mga health lecturer na yung sugar nakakahina ng immune system. So pag nung ginawa kong 2 months kahit walang sugar, humatching na sila at lagnatin na sila at yung mga kapitbahay ko, kasama ko sa bahay, tatawanan ko lang sila. So, this is an advantage. There is judgment according to the, just go to the blood pressure. Wag na kayong makipagdebate sa, mga kapatid, I just want to tell you, I have debated many people in Facebook regarding the health message. Every one of them got sick. You cannot debate the health message. It is a health law. It's like debating gravity. Hindi ako malalaglag dyan. Diba? It's a health law. Everybody who I debated with just got sick. I take them to the hospital or I bring them from the hospital. Because the health law is a law. Okay. Whether therefore you eat or drink or whatsoever you do, do all to the glory of God, the Holy Spirit which renews every organ. Wow! Ito yung maganda. Even if we have sins to our body, the Holy Spirit will renew every organ of the body, that God's servants may work acceptably and successfully. Do you know why we get well when we are sick? Isaiah 53 says, By his stripes we are healed. Because Jesus suffered, we become healed. Vitality increases under the influence of the Spirit's action. So when the Holy Spirit comes, He will renew every organ so that we can do lots of work. If we are not doing any work, what for? Diba? Romans 8:13, for if you live after the flesh, you shall die. But if you through Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, you shall live. I have a question. Paano si Pablo? May problema siya sa kanyang katawan. Panalangin siya ng panalangin. Siguro nag-fasting pa. Pero hindi sinagot ng Diyos yung panalangin niya sa 2 Corinthians. Yung kanyang thorn in the flesh. Bakit hindi sinagot yung kanyang panalangin? God did not renew his body. Of course, nakasulat din doon yung reason. Sabi ng Diyos sa kanya, my grace is sufficient for thee. Ibig sabihin, sa Tagalog, sa aking translation, matuwa ka na maliligtas ka, huwag ka na magreklamo. Ang pagkain din ni Pablo ay pag daw kasi siya gumaling sa kanyang thorn in the flesh, baka daw sa dami ng, for the multitude of revelations, yumabang siya at mawala pa siya dahil sa kanyang kayabangan. So minsan, hindi pinapantintulutan ng Diyos na gumaling tayo lahat para hindi tayo yumabang, according to the example of Paul. Okay. But God can fix everything, either now or in the second coming. Honor thy body, temple, beloved, now we are the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. Oh, this is a promise, for we shall see him as he is, so we will be changed. There is a problem. Our body temple has sin tendency to sin. These be who separate themselves, having not sensual, having not the spirit. So meron talagang laban. The lower passions and the Holy Spirit. Yung mga taong given to sensuality, wala nang inisip kundi kumain, at saka mag-type ng tatlong letter na word dun sa Google. Yung pinaka-popular daw na word sa Google. Hindi pwedeng banggitin kung ano. Sensual, having not the spirit. So there is a fight honoring the body temple. Yan, dinerecho na. Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God. That's why we're not supposed to commit adultery, right? Not only real adultery, there is also a different kind of adultery. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, it is written, do not commit adultery, but I say unto you, if you look at a woman lustfully, you are committing adultery with her in your heart. So, kayong mga girls, andyan ha, gising na po. Kayong mga girls, mag-iingat kayo sa pananamit ninyo na hindi kayo titignan namin na mga boys na magkakumit ng adultery. Kasi, hindi lang kaming mga boys ang magkukumit ng adultery. Bakit? Kaya mong mag-adultery mag-isa? Anong klaseng adultery yun? Ang adultery, at least two people. So pag kayo ay tiningnan with lust, kasama kayo sa adultery. With her in her eyes. Di ba? Yun ang sabi ni Jesus Christ when he expanded that thou shalt not commit adultery. Kaya mga kapatid, mga girls, sisters, alam naman po namin na ayaw niyong mag-commit ng adultery. Ang tanong, alam ko naman na gusto niyong sumunod, kaya lang marami ang hindi nakakaalam kung gaano kahaba ba talaga ang damit. Nasaan ang reference sa spirit of prophecy kung gaano kahaba ang damit? Marami akong kaibigan, binanatan ko sila ng binanatan, akala ko hindi na nila ako friend, pero nagbago sila, pastor. The word of the Lord through the prophets changes people. Kaya hindi ako natatakot. So, tingnan po natin. Dito sa 3SM 277.5. Tingnan niyo mga kapatid. Sabi doon, tinanong kasi si Ellen G. White, ganun ba kahaba yung damit? Sabi ni Ellen G. White, hindi ko alam sa inches. Pero may nakita akong vision o dream. May tatlong grupo ng babae na dumaan sa harap ko. Bago ko sabihin, makikita nyo naman, pag hindi nyo alam, God will forgive. Pero pag alam nyo na, may ukay-ukay dyan. O kaya may divisorya. Pag pastor, pag pinipreach ko ito, yung mga kabataan, hindi nagagalit. Ang nagagalit, yung matatanda. Akala ko yung matatanda yung mas maayos. Hindi ko lang maintindihan kung bakit ganun. So the three companies, yung una daw na company, mahahaba yung damit. Hindi lang mahahaba, sobrang haba, nawawalisan yung street. So yung mga dahon, kumakapit dun sa dress nila, sabi ni Ellen G. White, mali yun. It is not clean. Kasi nalilinisan nga yun, nawawalisan yung street. Yung pangalawa, hindi abot sa tuhod. Hindi na daw kailangan pagdebatehan kung tama o mali yun, dahil hindi nga abot sa tuhod. Kaya lang mga kapatid, hindi ko mailagay yung picture ng hindi abot sa tuhod dyan dahil titingnan ninyo yung mga nandun sa kabila ng damit. Diba? Matagal ko nang pinapangarap, Pastor, gumawa ng picture na ganito. Humanap ako mahabang damit. Pero pag humanap ako ng maikli, ay dun tayo titingin sa maikli. Paano ko ilalagay sa harap ng church? Mabuti na lang may nakita ako, maikling damit, pero may pants sa ilalim. So hindi yung pants ang pinag-uusapan natin, yung skirt na nasa ibabaw ng pants. No? Kaya yan may pants para lang hindi nyo tingnan yung... Okay, kaya ganyan yung nakita kong picture. At ang tama daw ay yung siyempre, yung abot dun sa gaiter boot. G-A-I-T-E-R. Sabi ko, saan yung gaiter boot? Hindi pa ako nakarinig ng ganun. So tinype ko sa Google Images, gaiter boot. Clinic ko yung images. Ang nakita ko, hanggang dito. Anong klaseng gaiter boot yan? Hanggang dito. Di conflict siya dun sa number 2. Mabuti na lang, Pastor. The Bible says, the Holy Spirit will teach you all things. Kaya ang tinype ko dun sa Google, gaiter boot 1800s. Oh, ang lumabas, hanggang dito. Average. Yung iba dito, yung iba dito. So, hanggang dyan, yung ibabaw ng gaiter boot. So, hindi siya sumasayad sa floor. Pag umaakyat kayo sa hagdan, hindi rin naaapakan. Tapos, pag hindi rin nakakatukso. Diba? Oh, amen. O nag-amen na yung mga boys. Okay. Ang hirap-hirap isermon nito. Okay, honoring the body temples. Temple. Do you think that the scripture said in vain, the spirit that dwelleth in us lusteth to envy? So, yan na naman, laban. Ye shall not go after other gods of the gods of the people which are round about you, lest the anger of the Lord be kindled. So, ito pa. When men and women are truly converted, they will conscientiously regard the laws of life that God has established in their being. Laws of life. Hindi yan lang health message. It is actually the laws of life. Okay. Now, I want to go for a time to our fundamental beliefs, number 22. It says Christian behavior. Sabi dito, mga kapatid, sabi dito, nasa ano yun? It also means that our bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit. We are to care for them intelligently. We have to exercise and rest. We are to adopt the most healthful diet possible. Ayan, very positively framed yung most healthful diet possible. Hindi sinabing, wag na kayo kumain ng isda. Hindi sinabing, wag na kayo kumain ng itlog. Hindi sinabing, wag na kayo kumain ng flesh food. Nilagay dyan, most healthful diet possible. Di ba po merong acceptable, ideal, saka abominable. Yung abominable, yung baboy, yung mga ganun. Yung acceptable, yung manok. Acceptable yan daw. Tapos yung best, yun. Mabuti na lang kayo na nagsabi. Share tayo. Ang nakasulat sa fundamental belief ay acceptable or best. Most healthful diet. Ah, baka nakalimutan natin yung ating fundamental beliefs. And abstain from unclean foods identified in the scriptures. Paano naging unclean yung manok? Paano naging unclean yung tuna? Sabi sa Forbes.com, Forbes magazine, the California tuna has traces of nuclear material from Japan. Paano nangyari yun? Sabi ni Ellen G. White, 150 years ago, yung fish sa dagat, because of the pollution in the sea, the fish will swim to another country maybe, or the ocean currents will go around. Kaya pala yung California tuna may traces ng ano sa Japan. Kaya 150 years ago, God sent message through the prophet Ellen G. White to warn us that the tuna will become toxic. Oh, di ba? Meron pang isa, yung inquirer7.net, yung malayo naman dito eh. Yung Kalamba Lake daw is not safe for humans and fish. Oh, kaya sinasabi ko sa mga kaibigan ko, pagkakain kayo ng isda, tatanungin niyo yung isda, saan ka ba galing? Galing ka ba sa Japan? O sa California? O sa ocean? O sa Laguna Lake? O sa Manila Bay? Pag hindi yan sumagot, guilty yan. But that is the health message. It is an advantage, no? Hindi tayo pinipilit pag hindi naniwala. Okay. Dahil sabi sa Leviticus 11:31-35, yung mga bagay na clean, pag nalagyan ng unclean, nagiging unclean na rin. Di ba yung palayok, nalagyan ng unclean, kailangan ng basagin. The principle is, yung mga clean na bagay, kahit na clean, kahit na apple pa yan, pag nilagyan mo siya ng galing dun sa Hiroshima, sa Japan, yung nuclear material, kahit pa apple pa yan, o isda pa yan, o manok, o ano nang yung kinakain nila, quail. Tanungin nyo yung Israelites sa quail. Kung clean ba yung quail o hindi. Pag hindi natanggal ang dugo nung manok sa Jollibee, Indian. Okay. Since the alcoholic beverages, tobacco, or you don't use that those things, right? We have to, we cannot use those. Isa pa. Matindi rin to. Listen. Dito sa, nakita nyo na tong book na to, yellow yan. The, from the General Conference Ministerial Department. Sa chapter, oh, nandiyan na. Sa chapter 22 niyan, 21, nakasulat po diyan ay ito, coffee, tea, and colas contain caffeine, and fruit-flavored wine coolers contain alcohol. Oh, hindi ko alam kung ano yung fruit-flavored wine coolers. Ang sabi naman po sa ito, tea, coffee, and tobacco are all stimulating. Hindi po ba nasa ano ito? Nasa baptismal certificate? Parang andun yata yun eh, itong coffee. Okay, just a reminder. So there are much of discussion, never take tea, coffee, beer, wine. This is in counsels to diets and food. And there is no food value. It stupefy transgressor, not the guiltless. We are losing the battle to appetite. Okay. And dyan nagsisimula ang intemperance. Ayan. Some think that they cannot perform reform and health would be sacrificed should they attempt to leave the use of tea, tobacco, flesh meats. This is the suggestion of Satan. Wow. Okay. Skip na tayo agad kasi baka batuhin na ako dito. Let's go back to our presentation. Honoring the body and temple. When men and women are truly converted, they will conscientiously regard the laws of life that God has established in their being, thus seeking to avoid physical, mental, and moral feebleness. Obedience to these laws must be made a matter of personal duty. Oh, walang pilitan. It is personal duty. We must answer to God for our habits and practices. Therefore, the question for us is not what will the world say, but how shall I, claiming to be a Christian, treat the habitation of God has given me? Okay. Whether therefore you eat or drink, do all to the glory of God. Okay, what else is one of the conditions for accepting, for outpouring of the Holy Spirit? A desire for Christ to abide in the heart. And he that keepeth his commandments dwelleth in him, and he in me, and he in him. And hereby we know that he abideth in us by the Spirit which He hath given us. 1 John 3:24. So Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit is inside us, and we are also inside, kasi yun nakalagay, in Him, dwelleth in Him, and He in Him, whereby we know that He abideth in us, which He hath given in us. So, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Wow, very nice promise. The question, there are things that promote the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the spiritual life. There are also things that drive away the Spirit. Paano natin bubugawin ang Holy Spirit? Paano natin bubugawin? Just in case you want. Of course, this is reverse psychology. We have to avoid driving away the Spirit because it is not good spiritual discipline. How oft did they provoke Him in the desert, grieve Him in the desert? They rebelled and vexed the Holy Spirit when He has turned. So, lahat yung conditions for accepting the Holy Spirit, pag binaliktad nyo yun, yun yung to drive away the Holy Spirit. Blaspheming, unbelief, blasphemy, not listening to the Holy Spirit, secondary concerns. We have primary concerns. We have secondary concerns. Right? Minor matters occupy the attention. So, if you think you need the Holy Spirit, maybe you are prioritizing the secondary concern. Pride and self-reliance, another problem. When I keep silence, my bones wax old through the roaring all day long. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not my Holy Spirit from me. When we are depending on our own things, we miss the Holy Spirit, and we are disqualified to do the work. Pag gumaganti tayo, that is also driving away the Holy Spirit. Ayan. Ito. Kalimutan niyo yung last slide. Pero ito mga kapatid, some of the parents, last Thursday, I met some of the parents of people here. Sabi nila, Sir, banatan mo ng banatan yung mga anak namin. So I was very encouraged to come and fire at all of you. Fire from the Bible and the spirit of prophecy. Intense amusements. Many have turned away God's plan to follow human inventions to the detriment of spiritual life, spiritual discipline. Friends, let's read the next sentence. Amusements are doing more to counteract the working of the Holy Spirit than anything else. Anong kalaban ng Holy Spirit na number one? Amusements. Ano yung mga amusements na kalaban ng Holy Spirit? Dire-diretso na natin. Itbulaga. Ano pa yung mga noontime bar na nasa TV? Kalaban ng Holy Spirit yan. Yung mga baril-barilan na games, thou shalt not kill. Yung mga nagnanakaw ng kotse na games, thou shalt not steal. Yung mga games na may mga hindi maayos ang damit ng mga babae dun sa games. Pure, Philippians 4:8, things that are pure, yun yung ating basehan ng mga bagay. Yung mga pocketbook, mga drama, exciting stories, love stories, nakasulat yan na those amusements are the number one to counteract the working of the Holy Spirit. And the Lord is grieved. Yan. So we have to be careful what kind of amusements we are trying to watch. Sabi dito, mga kapatid, number 22 fundamental beliefs of our church, it says, this means that our amusement and entertainment should meet the highest standards of Christian taste and beauty. Question, highest standards of Christian taste and beauty. Ang boxing po ba ay kasama sa highest standards of Christian taste and beauty? Hindi. Nasaan yan sa Bible? Philippians 4:8. Ayan. Whatsoever therefore is angry birds, no? It says whatsoever is lovely, whatsoever is true. So yung mga pocketbook na fiction, sa National Bookstore, may mga fiction, Hindi na yan kasama sa entertainment natin. Whatsoever is honest, yung mga agawan ng boyfriend, palabas, agawan ng asawa, whatsoever is just, whatsoever is pure, pag may nakita kayong picture sa Facebook na hindi pure ang naiisip nyo pag nakita nyo, hindi na yun kasama sa highest standards of Christian taste and beauty. Whatsoever is lovely, pag yung game nyo ay naggigibaan, it's not lovely, it's angry, hindi na yan kasama. If there be any good report, okay. So those are the things that we have to remember. Intense amusements. Number one, kaalaban ng Holy Spirit. Flee fornication. Every sin that man doeth, okay. 1 Corinthians 6:18. Minsan, pag pumupunta tayo sa mall, merong bagong binyag. Sabi niya, ang ganda sa Adventist Church. Kasi pumupunta ako dun sa ibang church, nakikita ko yung mga tao, nagkakasala ako. Pero pumasok ako sa Adventist Church, hindi niya natin tinapos yung sentence niya. Palagay ko ang sinasabi niya, may mga nakikita siya na hindi dapat niya makita sa loob ng church, na nagkakasala daw siya. Ano kaya yun? Sabi ni Job, I made a covenant with mine eyes. Why then should I think or look, sabi ang version, upon a maid? I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. I hate the work of them that turn aside. It shall not cleave to me. So what are we supposed to do? Instead of looking at things that are not pure, we should look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. So, these are the things that drive away the spirit when we don't believe. Nakasulat sa Bible, nakasulat sa SOP, nakasulat sa Adventist.org, nakasulat sa GC Ministerial Association na book, and we don't believe, the Holy Spirit is discouraged. Blasphemy, secondary concerns, we have to do evangelism, but we are doing other things. Pride, retaliatory spirit, intense amusements. And of course, the conditions are repentance, implicit trust, obedience, a burden to share, and persistent intercession. So let us pray as we close. Our Father in heaven, we have read your laws through the prophets. We thank you, Lord, for sending corrections to our spiritual life. We praise you, Lord, that you love us so much that you want to correct and fix us, Lord, so that we can live more like you and we will not crucify you again and again, Lord. Have mercy on our sins, Lord. We are fallen. We have evil tendencies. Please forgive us from all our sins. Forgive my fellow brothers and sisters for our mistakes in the past. Help us, Lord. Give us spiritual strength. Give us love for your word. Give us love for your work. Give us love for your church, Lord. Thank you for hearing and answering our prayers and for forgiving us from all our sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.